Dear students, today we are going to discuss about the in-text questions given in your textbook. The first one is, how would you determine the standard electrode potential of Mg2+/Mg? Now we have done one theory to measure the potential of any electrode. If you want to find out the electrode potential, a standard electrode potential of any half cell, I told you that half cell should be connected with C. So you can write the answer. Mg2+/Mg should be connected with C, standard hydrogen electrode. Right? Now you can connect. You can write like this. Mg/Mg2+, or if the salt is given, you can add MgSO4, MgCl2. Right? Double slash. H+(1)/H₂(1)/Pd. So the answer is, how will you determine the standard electrode potential? Answer is, by connecting that electrode with C. After connecting, then calculate E0 cell. So now what is E0 cell? E0 cell is equal to E0 reduction at cathode minus E0 reduction at anode. Right? So therefore, can I write like this? E0 reduction at cathode. Cathode is hydrogen. So therefore, I can write E0 cell is equal to 0.0, because you can see here E0 reduction at cathode is hydrogen, and we know the potential of hydrogen. Arbitrarily it is taken as 0. Right? So your answer will be minus E0 reduction at anode. Reduction at anode will be Mg2+/Mg. Right? Therefore, what will be your answer? Therefore, your answer will be E0 cell, which you have obtained, will nothing but it will be your E0 Mg2+/Mg. So you can write E0 Mg2+/Mg will be equal to minus E0 cell, or E0 Mg is equal to minus E0 cell, which you have determined. So this is your answer. This or this. So this is your first answer. Second is, can you store ZnSO4 solution in a zinc pot? Already we have done Daniell cell. In Daniell cell, zinc was acting as anode, copper was acting as cathode. Zinc undergoes oxidation. So Zn will be converted to Zn+2, and that combined with SO4. And this in 11th also we have done. So can you store it? Answer is no. No. We cannot store. CuSO4 solution. Because Zn undergoes oxidation, to Zn+2, and forms ZnSO4 solution. You can write like this: Zn solid, CuSO4 aqueous gives ZnSO4 solution plus Cu solid. So actually you want to store copper sulfate solution, but at the end of the reaction you can see copper metal is deposited and you are getting ZnSO4. So your copper sulfate solution cannot be stored in zinc sulfate. Yes, zinc pot, sorry. Because zinc is oxidized to Zn+2, which combines with SO4 and forms ZnSO4. So this is your second answer. Third is, suggest three substances that can oxidize Fe2+ under suitable condition from the table. The table is given in your book regarding standard electrode potential. The electrode potential of Fe3+/Fe is given 0.77 volt. Right? Now, What will be the answer? Answer will be those substances having higher E0 reduction than 0.77 volt will be stronger oxidizing agent, right? So here they have asked, suggest three substances that can oxidize Fe2 plus to Fe plus 3 under this condition, right? So if these are stronger oxidizing agent, then they can oxidize Fe2 plus. So what are the examples? Examples are fluorine, chlorine, oxygen. There are so many. Three are asked, so I am adding three. So these are your three index questions solved over here. Now, fourth question. Calculate the potential of hydrogen electrode in contact with a solution of pH 10. This is your question. Now, you can calculate this potential of hydrogen electrode in contact with a solution of pH 10. One short formula we have derived for JWE. Right, that I told you, that formula was pH is equal to E cell divided by minus 0.059 volt. But see, in board exam, they may ask you the method. So when they ask you the method, you have to write the method. So I will do this numerical by the method also, as well as in short for complete examination. Now you may know the answer from the short formula, right? Now we know that pH is equal to minus log of H plus to the base 10, right? Therefore, can I write pH is given 10 is equal to minus log of H plus. Therefore, what will be concentration of H plus? Concentration of H plus will be equal to log will go on opposite side. Anti-log of minus 10, and you know what is anti-log of minus 10? Anti-log of minus 10 is 10 raised to minus 10. So you got the concentration of H plus, right? Now, hydrogen electrode the following reaction takes place. H plus plus electron gives H2 gas. Now you know the next equation. N is therefore number of electron transfer will be 1 from this equation. So now according to next equation, what is our next equation? E cell is equal to E0 cell minus 0.059 by N log of product H2 by, but H2 it is nothing given, so it is 1 divided by H plus. For hydrogen, E0 cell is 0.0 minus 0.059 by N. N is 1, number of electron transfer is 1. You can see here. Into log of 1 upon 10 raised to minus 10. So this I can write minus 0.059 into log of 10 raised to 10. This is minus sign. So if it goes up, it becomes 10 raised to 10. So this will be equal to 0.059 into 10 log 10 to the base 10. And log 10 to the base 10 is 1. So your answer is minus 0.59 volt. Right? So this is your answer. So if this numerical is being asked in 2 or 3 marks, then you have to show the method. In short, or you can do it alternatively. Another method also you can use is, use it for competitive examination. We know that pH is equal to E cell divided by minus 0.059. Therefore, what will be your E cell? E cell will be equal to pH into minus 0.059. pH is 10, 10 into 0.059. Then also the answer is 0.59 volt. So this short formula you can use it in your competitive examinations. Right? So both the way you can do it. Either you can show the method if it is asked in the board examination, or you can use this formula when it is asked in competitive exam, or in case of MCQ. If it is asked in your regular exam. Clear? Now numerical number 5. Calculate the EMF of the cell. In which the following reaction takes place. Nickel solid given to you. Numerical number 5. Calculate the EMF of the cell. Means you have to find out E cell. In which the following reaction takes place. This is the reaction. Nickel is undergoing oxidation and Ag plus is undergoing reduction. Right? Concentrations are given, and when different concentrations are given, we have to use another sequence. Right? E0 cell is directly given to you. 1.052. So now we know that according to Nernst equation, can I write E cell is equal to E0 cell minus 0.059 by number of electron transfer. You can see here it is plus 2. Right? It is plus 2. Then log of ion product. Here you can say anode. Which is the ion? Ni2 plus. I will write it here. Divided by reactant. The ion at reactant side is Ag plus. But you can see here, it is multiplied by the stoichiometric coefficient is 2, so here you have to write it square. Now substitute the value. What will be E cell? E0 cell is 1.05 given to you. Minus 0.059 by 2. I told you approximately it is 0.03. Actually it is 0.0295. So carry on for it, it will be 0.3. Log of Ni plus 2. Ni plus 2 is 0.16. Divided by, yeah, I can write here, divided by Ag plus whole square. Ag plus is 0.002. So can I write? It will be 2 into 10 raised to minus 3 whole square. This value will be 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. Otherwise in decimal it will be difficult for you. So I can write it like this, right? So this will be equal to 1.05 minus 0.03 into log of, okay, one more, I will write it, into log of 0.16 also I can write 16 into 10 raised to minus 2, 16 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by square 4, and this will be 10 raised to minus 6. So this will be 4, 4 is 16, and this will be cancel out, it will be 6 will go up, so it will be 10 raised to 4. So I will write like this, 1.05 minus 0.03 into bracket, log of 4 into 10 raised to, 6 will go up, plus 6, plus 6 minus 2, plus 4. Now, you can see the log. 0.03. The log of 4, the value of log 4, it is 6021. But if I open the bracket, it will be log of 4 into means plus log of 10 raised to 4. 1.05 minus 0.03. Log of 4 is 0.6021 plus 4. Log 10 to the base 10 is 1, so 4 into 1. 1.05, 0.03, and this will be 4.6021. I will write it approximately. So 1.05, and if you multiply this 4.6 by 0.03, it will be 0.138. And if you subtract it, the value will be 0.914. So by this way you can find out your answer. So what is E cell of the cell? Plus 0.914 volt. Yes?
Now next, sixth. The cell in which the following reaction occurs. Fe3+ aqueous plus 2I- aqueous gives 2Fe2+ aqueous plus I2 solid has E0 0.236 volt at 298 Kelvin temperature. Calculate delta G0. Means standard Gibbs free energy and equilibrium constant of the cell reaction. Right? So now, what is given to you? You can check it. You are given E0 cell, right? Temperature. Whenever E0 is there, no need to write temperature. This standard 298. Cell is, reaction is given. From reaction, you can find out the value of N. And then delta G0 and K you have to find out. Let us see now. Again, I am repeating the question and I will explain you. The cell in which the following reaction occurs. This is the reaction 2Fe3+ plus 2I- gives 2Fe2+ plus I2. The potential, standard cell potential of this cell is 0.236 volt at 298. Calculate standard Gibbs free energy change and equilibrium constant of the cell reaction. And you know the relation between these two. You know the equation to find out K and E. That also we have done in the theory section, right? So first, using this, from the equation given, here you can say from the reaction given, can I write N is equal to 2, number of electron transfer, is it 3 to the 6 and 2 to the 4, so 6 minus 4 it will be 2, minus 2, right? So number of electron transfer are 2. Now, you know the relation. We know that delta G0 is equal to minus NF E0 cell. Substitute the value minus 2 96500 into E0 cell is 0.236 volt. So, if you multiply this, the value will be 45548. This is the value 45548, right? Joule per mole. This is your answer. Delta G, 0, which is being asked. You can convert, if you want to write in kilojoule, you have to divide by 1000. So it will be 45548. Now, again, to calculate the value of K, there are two possibilities. Two alternatives are there, right? You can use this equation which you have studied in 11. The relation between delta G0 and K is minus 2.303 RT log K. You can use this equation or you can use this equation. K is equal to NT log of E0 cell into N by 0.059. This I have taught you. We have derived this equation, right? Here also you can write K is equal to NT log of delta G0, minus sign will be there, so minus delta G0
upon 2.303 R into T. So both the way you can find out. Let us find out first by this way. Anti-log of minus, already minus sign is there, 4,5,5,4,8. Right. Divide by 2.303. The value of R in 11th standard you have studied in Joule, it is 8.314. Temperature is 298. Right? So if you calculate all this, if you divide it, multiply it, your value will be 7.9827. So if you take the anti-log, you can write like this. Anti-log of 7 plus 0.9827. Right? Then you can find out anti-log of, I am writing this value first, 0.9827. Now this is plus, so this will become multiplication. Anti-log of 7. And we know anti-log of 7. Anti-log of 7 is 10 raised to 7. And anti-log, if you look into your textbook, yeah, logbook, the value of anti-log of 9.9827 will be equal to 9.61. It is 961. So this is your answer. This will be your K. Let us see, this is also approximately equal to 10 raised to 8, because 9 point, if you carry on 1, it will be 10 raised to 8. Let us see here, anti-log of E0 cell is given, 0.236, number of electron transfer is 2, divided by 0.059, this will be, if you divide it, this will be 0.0295, and if you divide it, it will be anti-log of 8, and anti-log of 8 is 10 raised to 8. See? So by way, both the way you can find out the answer. Clear? Next question, number 7. Why does the conductivity of a solution decreases with dilution? Right? Or you can say on dilution. So the answer is, on dilution, the number of ions per unit volume decreases, and as number of ions per unit volume decreases, conductivity decreases. Because we know conductivity depends on number of ions, and here if you go on diluting the solution, number of ions per unit volume decreases, because volume increases and the ions per unit volume will decrease, so conductivity decreases. Question number 8, suggest a way to determine limiting molar conductivity limiting molar conductivity for a weak electrolyte water.
Now we know water is a weak electrolyte, and we have studied that for weak electrolyte it is not possible to determine lambda zero m experimentally, right? But using Kolmogorov's law we can calculate lambda zero m for water. So lambda zero m for water is equal to, now how will you suggest a way? It is algebraic addition and subtraction of some lambda zero m for strong electrolyte. So I will take lambda zero m. Now here I want H plus, right? So here I can take lambda zero m as well as I want it OH minus also. So lambda zero m will be, I'll take it plus lambda zero m plus lambda zero m, one will be minus. Now which I'll take minus? If I want H plus OH minus, I can take here NaOH. So from here I will get it OH, so I'll make it plus. Here I will make it minus. Now I want to remove Na, so I can take here NaCl. Now I want to remove Cl also, and here I want it H plus, so I can take HCl, right? Now what will be your values? Let us check lambda 0 m. Now open this, it will be lambda 0 m H plus plus lambda 0 m Cl minus. This is plus, now again minus sign. This will be lambda 0 m Na plus, but plus Cl minus, but in before that there is a sign negative, so it will be lambda 0 m Cl minus. Why I have taken like this? Because this minus minus will be cancelled, right? Then plus lambda 0 m Na plus plus, there is no problem here, already it is a plus sign, lambda 0 m OH minus, right? So plus lambda 0 m Na plus and minus will be cancelled. So using this lambda 0 m for strong electrolyte, now what is left? I got lambda 0 m H plus plus lambda 0 m OH minus, and we know this is equal to lambda 0 m water, right? So by this way you can calculate, this will be ionic molar conductivity, it is ionic molar conductivity. So different strong electrolytes you have to select, and then you have to do the algebraic addition and subtraction, so you can get the way to find out lambda 0 m, sorry, to calculate lambda 0 m for water. Clear? Now ninth question is, the molar conductivity lambda 0 m, sorry, the molar conductivity lambda m of 0.025 molar moles per liter methanoic acid, of 0.025 moles per liter methanoic acid is 46.1 siemens per centimeter, siemens centimeter square per mole, this is given to you, right? Calculate degree of dissociation. Degree of dissociation means alpha, calculate alpha, question mark, and dissociation constant, calculate alpha and dissociation constant Ka. Given lambda H plus is equal to 349.6 siemens centimeter square per mole, and lambda Ca3COO minus is equal to 54.6 siemens centimeter square per mole. These are the data given to you, and you have to find out alpha and Ka, right? Now First of all, you find out lambda 0m for H plus n, Ca3CO minus are given to you, right? Sorry, this is not Ca3CO minus, it is given HCOO minus because it is methanoic acid. So first of all, you find out the value. What will be? See, here lambda point, this one is given to you 46.1. To find out alpha, alpha we know, alpha is lambda m upon lambda 0m. So first of all, we have to find out lambda 0m of formic acid is equal to lambda 0h plus lambda 0HCOO minus, right? All values are given, put it. What is lambda 0h plus given? 349.6 plus 54.6. I am writing the unit outside, Siemens centimeter square per mole, right? And this will be equal to 6 plus 6, 12, carry on 1, 5 plus 1, 4, yeah, you can say 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 4, 14, carry on 1, 5 plus 1, 6, 6 plus 4, 10, carry on 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 404.2. Siemens centimeter square per mole. So this is your lambda 0m, right? Now you know alpha. What is alpha? Alpha, that is degree of dissociation, will be lambda m upon lambda 0m. This is your alpha. Lambda m is given 46.1 divided by 404.2. So this answer, if you calculate, it will be 0.114. This is your alpha. Now they have asked Ka. That also we have studied. Ka is equal to C alpha square upon 1 minus alpha. C alpha square upon 1 minus alpha. Now, as methanoic acid is a weak electrolyte, is a weak electrolyte, alpha is neglected. From 1 minus alpha. Alpha is neglected from 1 minus alpha. So if you neglect this alpha from 1 minus alpha, your Ka will be C alpha square. Now put the values. Value of C is given. It is how much? 0.025. And value of alpha, you have calculated 0.114 whole square. So if you multiply these two values, you will get 3.67 into 10 raised to minus 4 approximately. So this may be your answer, or you can divide it by alpha also, 1 minus alpha, 1 minus 0.114. So you multiply this value and divide by 1, yeah, less than 1 value, there will be not much difference in the answer. So by this way you can find out alpha as well as dissociation constant, acid dissociation constant Ka, clear? Number 10. If 0.5 ampere current flows through a metallic wire for 2 hours, then
how many electrons? Flow. Through the wire. Question mark. Okay. Now, question number 10. If 0.5 ampere current, so it's better to write what is given first of all. I, 0.5 ampere, right, flows through a metallic wire for 2 hours. Time is given, 2 hours. But we have studied that time should be in seconds, so can I write it into 3600 seconds? So it will be 7200 seconds, right? Because 2 hours you have to multiply by, convert it into minute and then into second, right? So 2 hours then I have written. How many electrons? So number of electrons are asked. Flows through the wire. Okay. Whenever I and T is given, first of all you have to find out the quantity of charge. Yeah, quantity of electric current, how much you are passing. And that also we have studied. We know that Q is equal to I into T. Right? I is equal to 0.5 into 7200. Right? And 0.5 into 7200, will it be half of 7200? 0.5. So this will be equal to 3600 seconds per coulomb. Right? Because unit of Q, quantity of charge, is coulomb. Now important point is, again we know that charge carried by one mole of electron is known as 1 Faraday. Charge carried by one mole of electron is known as 1 Faraday. And in the theory section we have done it. What was the charge carried by one mole of electron? That is 1 Faraday. 1 Faraday is equal to 96500 coulomb, right? But 96500 coulomb is the charge carried by one mole of electron. So can I write 96500 coulomb is for one mole electron? That is equal to 6.02 into 10 raised to 23 electrons. Therefore, I have passed how many? How much? 3600 coulomb. So it will be how many electrons? Directly you can find out the number of electrons. So therefore, number of electrons is equal to cross multiplication. 3600 into 6.02 into 10 raised to 23 divided by 96500. So this 00 is cancelled out, and if you divide it, your answer will be equal to 2.2 into 10 raised to 22. So approximately you can write 2.25 into 10 raised to 22 electrons will flow through the wire. This is your answer. Okay.
Now, question number 11. Suggest a list of metals that are extracted electrolytically. This is your question. Suggest a list of metals that are extracted electrolytically. So what will be your answer? Metals on the top of reactivity. Series R. Metals on the top of the reactivity series are lithium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, and so many, etc. are extracted. Electrolytically. So this is your answer. Metals on the top of the reactivity series like lithium, sodium, calcium, potassium also you can write it. All these are extracted electrolytically. Now question number 12. Consider the reaction Cr2O7 2 minus plus 14H plus plus 6 electron gives 2 Cr3 plus plus 7H2O. What is the quantity of electricity in Coulomb needed to reduce 1 mole of Cr2O7 2 minus 2? Sorry, 1 mole of Cr2O7 2 minus. This is your question. So consider this reaction. Reaction is given to you, right? What is the quantity of electricity in Coulomb needed to reduce 1 mole of Cr2O7? Look to this question. And in the question itself, the reaction given is Cr2O7, 1 mole Cr2O7. If you want to reduce, you require 6 electrons, means 6 moles of electron. So to reduce 1 mole, Cr2O7 2 minus, we require 6 electron, that is equal to 6 Faraday, that is equal to 6 into 96500 Coulomb. So it will be 0, 0, 65 is 30, carry on 3, 66 is 36, 37, 38, 39. 96 are 54, 55, 56, 57. This much Coulomb. This was being asked. And this type of questions are also asked in the competitive examinations.
one more question is there. Question number 13. In fuel cell, which fuels are used other than hydrogen? Answer you can write: methane. This also we have done in theory. Methanol. So these are your question number 11, 12 and 13. Okay. Now tell them that you will send them the homework by WhatsApp. You then, sir? Hello? दस मिनट से तो ये नहीं करता, वी स्टॉप हियर टुडे.